The Aegeus Bowl hosted the second ODI between England and South Africa, with the hosts leading the series 1-0. Three changes for the visitors: Maharaj, Pretorius and Berhardine coming into the starting lineup. All the one change for England, as Wokes failed to come through a quad niggle picked up at Headingley. South Africa won the toss and elected to bowl, and after a couple of early boundaries, they had the early breakthrough.
Got in! 93.2 miles an hour, too quick for Jason Roy.
Root was the new man in, and he and Hales built a solid partnership. New man Pretorius, the bowler, who seemed most to their liking.
Definitely England are looking to attack.
Hales had an escape when he was put down by Rabada, but just a few balls later, he wasn't so lucky.
A costly drop, what we thought would cost him a lot of runs, hasn't happened. Hales has just nicked one through.
Morgan started brightly on a ground where he averages over 70 in ODIs. But it wasn't long before he was looking for a new partner, as Root was dismissed in the cruelest of ways.
Oh, surely not. Root has played so well. He's at the non-striker's end backing up. The bowler has got a little piece of that with his hand as Morgan drives.
Ben Stokes was the new man in, and the IPL MVP looked scratchy during his first few overs at the crease, in much the same way as he'd struggled in Leeds.
Another drop.
But after giving up that series of opportunities, both batsmen began to find their feet.
There's six of them. Four. One bounce. Not in his porridge. In the gap. Beautiful shot. Great placement. Four.
Sounded sweet. I think it's going a long, long way. Edged, I think, and it's taken, yeah. And that is a big wicket for South Africa.
A fine catch from de Kock. Morgan on his way for 45. Josh Butler, the new man in, a player in need of runs. But in the early part of his partnership with Stokes, Butler was very much playing second fiddle to the Durham man. A 77-ball ton, showing why England was so desperate for Stokes to overcome his knee injury.
Makes it. 100 for Stokes.
However, he was not to push on.
That's a powerful strike. What is he going to carry it all the way? No gone.
Butler and Ali combined well in the closing overs to push England up to a very competitive total.
Oh, well. That will be his half century.
Another valuable contribution from Butler later in.
Another boundary. A slower ball. On a long way up. And Quinton de Kock says it's mine.
330-6 England score. Stokes 101 the standout performance. But he was ably backed up by Butler at the tail end of the innings. The keeper's 65 not out, a welcome return to form ahead of the Champions Trophy. Rabada was easily the pick of the South African bowling, although Maharaj could have been looking at very different figures had the catches been taken. So, 331 to win for the Proteas, 6.62 the required run rate. The opening 10 overs featured a fascinating duel between Amla, de Kock and Wood and Ball.
That's four. Ooh, that was quick.
It hit him hard and it shook him up quite seriously there.
Should be four more.
England required a breakthrough, so Morgan turned to Stokes.
Ball come! Caught a short extra cover.
Duplessis joined de Kock and they put on a quick fire 37.
Four.
Yeah! Well, it's an edge.
De Villiers came in to partner de Kock, and the skipper built upon his form from Headingley, partnered by some excellent batting from de Kock, who moved to his 50 in the process.
He's got himself set here and knows now that he's got to push on.
With the run rate at 8, 18 overs remaining, South Africa looked in control of the chase, England in desperate need of a wicket.
To 50 for AB de Villiers. Oh! Has it carried? Butler likes it.
England put the pressure on in the next few overs and struck a vital blow when de Kock fell too short of his century.
Yeah! Given! No 100 for de Kock this time, 98, two runs short.
120 were required with 14 overs remaining. England slightly in the ascendancy, but Miller started to build momentum.
What a wonderful shot that is.
Morris joined Miller and they turned the game firmly in South Africa's favour.
It was length and it's gone maximum. Up and over. He's not running, Miller, and you can see why. Hit hard. Hit seriously hard. It's gone for four.
The final over started, with South Africa needing seven to win. Mark Wood, the bowler.
South Africa one hit away. Pulled hard at square leg, nearly took the square leg umpire out. And is there an appeal? There's an appeal. They want one for the wide. South Africa's looking.
327 for five. One ball to go. Four to win, South Africa.
Misses it. And what a finish from England. What a comeback. Again, they were losing eight deliveries ago. Wood has bowled a magnificent final over. He's only gone for four. And England not only win this match, but they win the series. What an outstanding game.
A remarkable final over from Wood, winning the series for England. South Africa 328 for five. England victorious by two runs. De Kock, the top scorer with 98. Miller so nearly winning it with an unbeaten 71 off 51 balls.
My mouth is so dry, still off just that nervous energy at the end. You try and stay calm and focused on what you're trying to do, but underneath it's like you're a barrel of nerves. But I had a clear plan, that was to bang the ball in. It was too paced. If I changed my plan and went full, me and Morgie kept saying, shall we go at the heel, shall we try and get a Yorker in? I think if I changed that plan and getting it wrong, I would have regretted it. So we're stuck with the plan and luckily today came off.
But in the end, England's bowlers doing just enough. Plunkett with three wickets, but Wood and Stokes the meanest with the ball, with economy rates under five. The final match of the series takes place at Lord's on Monday.